Hello, and welcome to Faith Fellowship's Daily Word of Encouragement. I'm Walter, and this is my lovely wife,
Ramonda.
And today we're going to talk to you about refinement or purification.
Mm-hmm. Yes, so I was driving home on one day last week, and God spoke that exact word to me, purify. And it was just so heavy. It really rested on me. And I came home, and because Walter and I, when we get words from God or when we have God showed up moments, we always document them, write them down so that we can go back and look at it at another time. So when I came home, I was really burdened with that word because I really feel that someone needs to know that that's who He is. He is our refiner. We are not perfect. God, every day, he wants to continue to pull us and draw us near to Him, to take us and shape us and mold us to who He's called us to be. And sometimes when we make mistakes, we feel that we can't start over, or, you know, we feel like, oh, I've sinned, or I messed up. You know,
and it's broken beyond repair.
Exactly. And it's hard for me to get back up again, like that song, Dunny McClurkin, "We Fall Down, But We Get Up." And so anyway, that word purify came to me, and I asked my husband, babe, can we just look through the Bible and see what the Lord is saying when He placed that word in my spirit? And what did you find, babe?
I found Proverbs 25, verse 4. Which says, take away the dross from the silver, and the smith, or the silversmith, has material for a vessel. And so, looking up what the dross is, mm-hmm. So as the smith is boiling that molten silver, yeah. The impurities come to the top, and they take them off, and then they keep boiling it, and they take the impurities off until they get it just pure.
Yeah.
And then they pour it into a mold and make it into a vessel, mm-hmm. which is beautiful and pure.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. So it's just like, you know, the more we pray and we seek God's face for those things that we are struggling with in our lives, those heart areas that, you know, we just can't seem to overcome, He is the refiner. He wants to refine you. He wants to purify you. And He's there with His hands stretched out and saying, come to me, you know, my child, and I will help you with those things, things that we never talk to people about that we're struggling with. God is for us, and He just wants to continue to pour into us, shape us, and mold us. And I think there is another scripture that really talks about transforming us, and He's the potter, and, mm-hmm. and we're the clay, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so where do we find that scripture?
Jeremiah 18, verse 3 through 6 says, this is Jeremiah, says, so I went down to the potter's house, and I saw him working at the wheel. But the pot he was shaping from the clay was marred in his hands. Mm-hmm. So the potter formed it into another pot, shaping it as seemed best to him. Then the word of the Lord came to me. He said, can I not do with you, Israel, as this potter does, declares the Lord?
So good, right? What are your thoughts on that scripture?
Well, He's constantly making and molding us into yeah. what He wants.
Right.
Right? So it's a work.
Yeah.
Right?
It's a process. It is. It's a process. It is. And so, again, I don't know who this is for. And it's for me. I'll say that it's for me because...
I'll take this for me, too.
Because none of us have arrived. All of us, you know, we have flaws. You know, we have things that we're taking to the Lord in prayer every day, asking God to help us with that. And I think I just want you to know that He loves you. You know, God loves you, and He wants the best for you. And no matter what you do, when you ask for forgiveness, God forgets it. He's not like man. He doesn't hold it over our head, right?
Right.
He forgives us. And
and you're not stuck with it. He's continually taking stuff yeah. away, taking
refining.
Impurities away, refining.
Refining.
So another verse is in James chapter 1, verse 4. It says, let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not yes. lacking anything.
Yeah.
And then another one to finish up, Philippians 1:6. Yeah. Being confident of this very thing, that he who began a good work in you yeah. will complete it until yeah. the day of Jesus yeah. Christ. So either when we go home or when he comes to get us,
right.
he's going to keep working on us.
Exactly. Because he has a purpose for your life. So every morning when I wake up, I say, Lord, what do you have, not for me today, but what do you have for us today? Because I can do nothing without him. I've tried it. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. So, and every day my prayer also is that he will continue to refine me, to burn away anything that keeps me from drawing closer to him and being more and more like him. So we hope this word
encourages you.
Yes.
And please do remember to subscribe and click the bell so you get notified every time there's a new daily word of encouragement.
God bless you.